Yup, hi. This is FN here from Goa once more, taking you on my web journey through the sites and spaces which I find interesting in cyberspace. This time looking at the GoaNet history through photographs, Google Images, going back, as I said, a long time. 26 years, not all of them that old, of course, but some of them quite old. We've shared the images are up there, and it's really nice to go back and to remember all these things that we encountered. The first picture is one of the earliest GoaNet meetings which we used to have. We still try to have it, pandemic year apart. At the end of the year, when traditionally many Goans visit Goa, and GoaNet membership has been a lot, you know, consisting of the diaspora community. So when they come down, we have this meeting, and this was held at the International Center. If I remember right, Samir Kerekar, engineer, Bangalore, still very much in Bangalore. Peter D'Souza, a Goan in the US. And the journalist from Bombay who also had come for the meeting. And this was around 95-96, International Center, Dona Paul. Of course, Herman Carneiro, the founder of the GoaNet, sitting on this very table where I'm sitting and recording. in the very next to my dining table and things like that at my home. This is probably around early 2000s when I did an interview with him. I forget the exact date. And GoaNet took part in one of the Konkan Fruit Fest organized by a friend, Miguel Braganza, who used to be very active on the net, on GoaNet once upon a time. In some cases there were misunderstandings and people moved out or left us or whatever. So, but at that stage we had taken part, and this is the GoaNet logo also. I don't remember who designed it, but it was a GoaNet logo which came about probably in the late 90s. This is again another of the meetings which was held at the Caritas Hall in Panjim. I remember very clearly some of the members who were present there and things like that. Oops, I've clicked on the wrong page, and that has taken me to the GoaNet page on Wikipedia. Why not? It's one of the resources also. So in this photo, which should be on Wikimedia Commons, who can we see there? Father Desmond D'Souza, Redemptorist, great guy. He told us a story of how he ended up eating balut, which is some kind of half-hatched egg, when he was in the Philippines. So Joel D'Souza and Dan Driscoll. We'll come back to later. Alexi. A few others who... John Eric Gomes. A few other guys who have been there. This is Minin Rodriguez, a prominent Goan from Karachi, now also in North America. He has put together a website. He had put together a website called goansofpakistan.com or .org. Now he's made a book out of it. This was one of our December meetings in at the Miramar residency, probably around 2007 or thereabouts, I'm guessing. Now this meeting and this meeting are the same ones. We have Ashank Desai speaking to GoaNetters, probably 96, because we had access to the net, we were able to find a whole lot of track a whole lot of Goan achievers who had been largely ignored back home. So Ashank is an alumni of the Goa Engineering College who has set up, he was one of the co-founders of Mastek, if I get the designation right. Mastek is a software company which was in those days having a turnover of 250 crores, 2500 million rupees. And back home he was not even being properly recognized or acknowledged as such. So we called him and he came over, and he's addressing us in his formal attire, which was quite untypical of us. Then we have Peter and another lady from the US at that very same meeting again, Bosco DeMello. Been an admin for a long time, done a whole lot of work, contributed a lot to keeping GoaNet going. The kids around, this is the same meeting as the Karachi Goan meeting in the Mandovi Riviera. So we actually invited as a chief guest, or whatever you call it, this how old was she? She was maybe 8 or 9 or 12. She was this Goan kid, not 12, probably less, Ivana Gomes, who was a chess champion internationally, and she agreed to play a game against 8 or 9 or 10 Goan children simultaneously, and she beat all of them in a matter of a few minutes. Here, this is Ivana playing with some of the kids. As she moves table to table, the rest are all kind of playing with her, playing against her. Eddie Fernandez, one of the early admins and proponents of GoaNet, who subsequently went on to build goanvoice.org.uk, goanvoice.org.uk. Still today a very interesting informative site about whatever is happening in the Goan world in cyberspace. This is Leera and our journalist friend from Bombay. I'm finding it a bit hard to keep track of which photos are linked to GoaNet. So I think there was a major GoaNet meeting in Canada at one stage, and this is probably Ben Antao and the audience there talking to some of them and discussing his work and his book. So Ben is an author. Ben has been active on GoaNet. Many members of GoaNet along the way have moved on, moved off, got irritated with it, not agreed with its policy, which is part of growth, which is part of growing up and changing tracks. So we still consider them as friends, but they may not be active on the net. This is, if I'm not mistaken, my picture from the International Center meeting, one of the early ones. The other meeting we were referring to at the Miramar Residency, Foodland. Okay. Anna Maria Goswami and Jason Montserrat, who was a youngster into sports and writing on sports and things like that. My regret is I didn't manage to push him enough to do that book he was planning on sports. I really don't know what's this. First time I'm seeing it. Unscrambled GoaNet. 92 words found in GoaNet. Word unscrambler, whatever that is. Yeah, I remember this guy, though I'm forgetting the name, with his camera and things like that, for one of our meetings. Again at International Center. Some of these may not be GoaNet pictures, but they were posted on GoaNet, so they are in some way connected with the diaspora. So you have this Goan International Convention 2008. I don't think we were directly associated with it, but just probably reported it or something of that sort. Dan Driscoll, amazing guy. A Canadian married to a Goan lady, lived in Goa, till his late 80s or was it early 90s, went back to Canada, passed away, no more. I've never seen such an encouraging person who would support us in all we did, and it's really touching to remember him. This is from the Goan International Convention, which Goanet played a part in at Canada, if I'm not mistaken. The caption reads, "Wo ani Diotsar Korn Kai." Who the heck is this devil? So I don't know who they are referring to there. But looking at the picture, I guess it must be by our famous friend Edgar Silveira, who is extremely good at these pictures which focus in on part of the subject with a lot of blurry outside focus and things like bokeh or whatever it's technically called. This is a meeting at a Guanetal meeting at Finding It Hard to Recollect. Is it the fourth Aguada? There's Cecil Pinto there. There's a very young looking Father Ariosto, if I'm not mistaken, and one or two others. Prabhakar Timble, who is addressing the Goa Netters meeting at the International Center 23 years ago. Professor Timble was then, if I'm not mistaken, the principal of the Kepe Government College, and subsequently he moved on and became the election commissioner of Goa and held many posts. Very, very articulate, sharp thinking person. Some of these are false positives. They are not kind of in any way linked to GoaNet, but some of them are. So here's George Pinto speaking, I don't know where. So George has been very active with GoaNet from the initial stages itself, almost the beginning, if I'm not mistaken. And he's come around and joined us for many meetings. Sometimes we've held joint meetings between his organization called Goa Sudharop, which in a way probably could say grew out of GoaNet and GoaNet too. This is a meeting at the Miramar residency. A lot of thumbs ups. You can see me in the corner with beard and hair. Beard is black almost. And the GoaNet Goa Sudharop meet of December 2017. This is at the photo for some reason is quite blurred. I think it's low res or I don't know what. So this is at Miramar Club Gaspar Diaz. Not related to GoaNet, but one photo shared on GoaNet. This is a painting, of course, by AX Trinidad, the Rembrandt of the East, on display at the Fundação Orient, where we've also had one of our GoaNeters meetings along the way. We've had it at the Xavier Center, at some other places. I think with this we seem to be running out of the GoaNet meetings. Late Dr. Cornel de Costa, who was very actively involved with GoaNet at one stage. At one point some of the returned expats from Kenya, Betsy Pinto, together with a lot of women, set up FemNet, which was part of GoaNet also, as it says here, powered by GoaNet. And it was an attempt to give women a voice on GoaNet, because we've always had skewed kind of gender ratios on GoaNet. So Betsy started FemNet, and that worked quite well. Another picture from our meeting, obviously Dr. Celsa Pinto and the former director of education, and Minin from Pakistan, Minin Rodrigues. Looks like that's it. Keep calm and arm. I was Guanet. I mean, I don't know where this comes from, but interesting. So, on that note, we would wind up. Thanks for being with us. Thanks for listening.